this is the Samsung Galaxy S3. First I'm going to show you a bit of the hardware. I'm going to show you how you pull the phone apart and take the battery out and put the battery back on, and show you how to turn the phone on, and then we'll go on from there. Okay, so first of all, this is what the Galaxy S3 looks like. Gorgeous phone. You've got your volume controls there at the side. You've got your turn on button on this side. At the top here, you've got your, let me just zoom in a little bit, or try to. You can plug in your headset and stuff like that. Okay, now to take the back off, if you turn the phone over, at the top here, if you use your fingernail, it's on poppers, so as you can see, the phone comes off, and this is what the phone looks like in the back. You can see your camera lens and everything like that. Now, to remove the battery, you put your finger in here and just lift it out, and that's what it looks like on the inside of the phone. So whenever you get asked for your IMEI number, it's usually on the back here. It's a really cool phone. Your SIM card goes in here. Easy to get out and easy to get in. Okay, now, so when you get asked to remove the phone, if your phone ever gets stuck, that's how you remove your phone. Now, to put the battery back in, it's easy enough. You simply just push it, and then your back is just on little poppers. So you just line it back up and pop it all in, and that's the phone back together. Now, to turn it on, it's just this button here at the side. As you can see, that is now the phone turning on. This version of the Galaxy S has Jelly Bean on it, which makes the phone a lot faster, and it's a lot like running your hands through butter. Let's just zoom in slightly. Oh, we're looking very dark at the moment, too dark, so if you just give me... As you can see at the moment, the phone is showing really, really dark, so I need to go into settings. And you can go into display, go into brightness, and for some strange reason the brightness on the phone is really far down, so let's brighten it up so we can show you. And that's the phone brightened up, which already is much, much better. On this you can also change how, when your phone goes to sleep and things like that. So there's a lot you can do on the settings. You've got your Wi-Fi, your Bluetooth, your data usage, you've got your interface stuff, so you can get, so you can lock screen, set a password and stuff like that. You can adjust the sound and the volume. So this is where you can adjust the sound and the volume. You can change your ringtone, you can put your vibrate on or turn your vibrate off. Touch sounds, so when you use your keyboard it can bleep. You can also control the volume of that as well. So we go back out, which is great. You can see these little bits at the bottom, they light up. And that's so you can control your phone, so you can go into menu and bits and bobs like that. Okay, let's just pop back into settings for a minute. So you also can have a look at your battery and see how well your battery is doing. You can change your profiles, which are your Google profiles. So if you've got more than one Google account, you can just go into there and change it and set it all up so you have, you can swap Google accounts when you go into the Play Store and bits and bobs like that. As well as it shows you your applications, and in your applications you can turn notifications off. So if you go into apps here, and if your Facebook ones are driving you insane, go into the ones that are running and it will show all of those. Or if you go into all, this is where you can have a look in your notifications. So let's see if we can find one that is worth showing. So if you go into Facebook here, you can see you can turn off your notifications just here. You can also uninstall and force stop, so it just stops looking at Facebook. So it gives you a massive choice of things that you can actually do, which is fantastic. So we go back out of there. As you can see all your apps on there, and you can control all of them from this point. But that is your settings, very easy, very easy to use, fantastic really. So let's go back out of there. As you can see on your home screen, you can set it up so you've got all your games on there. But if you want more games on there, if you just go into the middle one here, you can move things. So if you hold your finger down, and there you go, you can just move it onto your home screen. Now if you don't want that on there, you can click like so. Also, the game is fantastic for playing games. So let's have a quick look into Garfield Diner. I haven't actually played it on this version of this phone yet. So let's just zoom in a little bit so you can have a good look. Sorry, a moment while I adjust the focus. It's always a pain in the bum. So sorry if it's a little bit out. This is actually quite a cool game. It's actually Garfield's Defense, not Garfield Diner. So if we go into play, I actually find this game quite difficult, but that's just me. You can upgrade all your bits in here, so you need to collect cookies. So far I've only got 13, but this is where you collect your cookies up. And if you press continue after you've sort of upgraded things, it'll take you into the game. And click next again. As you can see on those screens, it showed you what weapons you can get and what weapons you can put into it. You've got to collect popcorn and things like that. You need to bring up your guys to come and help you. Otherwise, what you're doing is you're trying to save the fridge. So if we just keep clicking on that to build these guys up. So as you can see, the game is really, the phone is very good for running games. Just waiting for that to, there we go, now we can get a cat in as well. How cool is Garfield? Don't we all just love him? I'm going to die. As you can see, the game is quite tricky. You definitely need your companions to come and help. And they'll keep fighting for you. Oh no, dead. Well, anyway, that's Garfield Defense, a really cute game. So as you can see, the phone plays games really well. I'll be zooming back out. Right to the back. Just click home. So that was the first game I was going to show you on here. Quickly zoom back in, quick focus. There we are, very nice. Okay, you can also check your Gmail accounts and stuff like that on here through Google+ and stuff like that. You've got your gallery which saves all your photos. Really, really cool. And you can just go to your camera here. You can take pictures. If you want to see the picture you've just taken, you can scroll with your finger and it brings it back up. So very, very cool. You've also got Chrome here so you can check on the internet and stuff like that. Which is really, really good. So really your home screen is absolutely fantastic and you've got loads and loads of space to put lots and lots of apps on as well as widgets. Now if you want a widget on your home screen, if you go into widgets here, grab the clock and hold your finger down and pop it there. If you don't want it on, hold your finger off and just swipe it away up to remove and it takes it back off. Thing I'm going to show you is Google Now, which as you can see is on the top of the bar here, and you can actually talk to your phone to get it to search for things. Really cool. So if you hold your finger here, it brings it up. Doctor Who. I don't know why I thought I said free apps when I didn't. Let's try that again. Doctor Who. It'll find the words and there we go, it brings it up. You can also go into images at the bottom if you want to see images of Doctor Who. It's mostly David Tennant. Meow. So really, really cool. Olympics. It'll bring up stuff about the Olympics. Shows how well we're doing. We're not doing very well at all. We're at number 21. That's really, really bad. China at the top, but they are absolutely fantastic. I was watching them on gymnastics the other day, absolutely brilliant. And that is Google Now, very, very cool. You can also search for places and stuff like that. So, where should we look for? London. And there we go, and it brings up London. It's really cool. If you click on more, you can get the news, shopping, videos, blogs, discussions, and books. So you can pretty much search for anything just by talking to your phone. Very, very cool. Okay, at the top of the phone you have your notification bar, which is a slider that comes down. This is really, really cool because when you get Facebook alerts and stuff, it shows up in there. So if someone posts a picture, you can see the picture in there and it looks really great. And you can just click on it to then go to what you need to. That's notifications. Also at the top, you've got your time, you've got your battery, you've got your reception, and you've got your Wi-Fi showing, as well as it will also tell you whether you've got your phone on silent or full blast. At the moment it's on silent. Okay, now the phone does play other games as well, which you can get from the Play Store, which is somewhere here. You'll notice when you go into your apps and you look for things, everything is in alphabetical order, which makes things really easy. Okay, so in the Google Play Store you can look for books, apps, movies, games. If we go into apps, it'll give you staff recommendations, editor's choice. You can have a background at the moment, which is Jelly Belly, which is jelly beans. It's really cool. I have it on one of my other phones. Also go into games, where you can look at the featured, which shows you some of the most popular. You can go into categories if there's a certain thing you're looking for. You can go into top paid, top free, and top grossing, just by sliding your finger across. Top new for pad, top new free, and all the stuff like that. Also, if you want to search for something, you just click here. Now you can either talk to it and type in what you want to look for, or you can just type in there. So yeah, really, really cool. Now also with this phone, which I'm just going to quickly show you because I think it's really cool, you can actually watch a video while doing other things. So if I go into the gallery, eventually it'll go in, there we go. Suddenly it's gone a bit slow. Ah, there we go, I just clicked on the wrong one. Unfortunately I've got no videos to show you at the moment, so that's a bit of a shame. Maybe do it on another video that I make. Okay, so other cool games that you can play on here is Amazing Alex, done by the same people that did Angry Bird. Just wait for it to load, and we press play. Go into classroom, that's where we started off. We'll just click on number 3. At the start of the game, it will show you how to play it and what you need to do. Okay, so as you can see at the moment, it's circling that there, so we need to get that ball there. So if we move this table here, and then just press the play at the top, you've got to collect the stars to get your points. Yay! So we got the little ball into it. Really, really cool. So that's 3 stars, and then you just click next to go on to the next one. It wants us to set tables up again. We do it like this, and then we press play. So we want to get all these 3 stars. Bingo! Yay! I really like Amazing Alex, it's such a cool game. The game does get harder and harder the more you play it as well, and as you can see I've just made a mistake, so if we press stop it will restart it. So it wants us to put a crayon here. And we'll try again, there we go. Like dominoes. And that is Amazing Alex. Really fun to play on this phone. Well, as you can see, there is a lot you can do with this phone. You can even have an app that tells you all about the Olympics and what's going on. Oops. Which is quite a cool app. Obviously, the Galaxy S3, you know, it's a great phone. I think it beats the iPhone and I just absolutely love it. And I want to try the Note one next, Galaxy Note 2. Sounds exciting. Anyway, that is the Galaxy S3, a really lovely phone. Really great once you've got Jelly Bean on it, and it is just like running your fingers through butter. Lovely, lovely phone.